Hello, everyone. David Adler, President of the Australian Jewish Association here, and I have a very special guest to talk to, someone who came to prominent attention for getting arrested by the Israeli police on Har HaBayit. Her name is Lauren Isaacs. Lauren, welcome to the Australian Jewish Association. Who is Lauren Isaacs?
First of all, thank you for having me. Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here with you. So basically, I run Chirut Canada, which is, I'm the national director of Chirut Canada. It's a Zionist education organization in Canada. Right. And I also work with the headquarters in Israel. And I live in Israel right now, thank God. And the Temple Mount is an important issue for me, as I hope it is for the entire Jewish and Zionist world.
Well, it certainly should be. So recently, you went up on Har HaBayit, Temple Mount. Now, you took an Israeli flag. Just talk us through what actually happened.
So I went up, I ascended as I like to do once or twice a year. It's the holiest place in Judaism. And I feel very connected there as an Orthodox Jew. It's very important to me. And I went with an Israeli flag. Don't ask me how I got it up. That's a trade secret. But I got the flag up and I opened it when we were in a specific location that I felt inspired. I opened it. I'm very nationalistic. I'm a huge Zionist. I'm a proud Jew. And I think all that is reflected in opening the Israeli flag and waving it proudly, no matter where we are. And then I held it for about 30 seconds. It was held open for about 30 seconds before the Israeli police came and told me to cease and desist. And they basically said, you know, leave the group, come over here with us. And then they said, you're under arrest. And I was like, what? I'm under arrest? Yes, you're under arrest. So they took me off and they gave me a good scolding, you know. But honestly, I have nothing against the police. I want to make that clear. I'm very pro-police. They do a great job. They're heroes who protect our country every day. But yes, unfortunately, in this instance, I was arrested, and it's honestly ridiculous. It's ridiculous that a Jew can't open an Israeli flag in Israel, in the holiest place for Jews, no less.
Now, perhaps the issue is that you took the wrong flag. Maybe you should have taken a Hamas or Hezbollah flag or even an ISIS flag. What would have happened if you'd taken one of those up?
Exactly. And we see that all the time in the news where there's been Hamas flags, ISIS flags flown there, Palestinian flags. Nothing happens. Nothing happens. The flags are sometimes taken down if they're actually displayed. And that's it. No one gets in trouble. But God forbid an Israeli opens an Israeli flag in Israel and, you know, they get arrested.
Well, this is actually quite serious. I mean, it's discrimination against Jews. You could go up there with a flag of the Palestinian Authority or any other entity, but it seems the only flag that you can't open on Har HaBayit is the flag of Israel or similar. So it's a big issue.
Yeah, that's the truth. And it's honestly, it's an embarrassment. I'm nationally embarrassed that is the way it is, that we can't open the Israeli flag up there. And that's why, you know, I did it. I'm a proud Jew. I'm a proud Zionist. And I believe the more we do it, the more we normalize it, the more people will begin to accept it, and hopefully it will become less taboo.
Well, at the end of this video, I will insert a picture, the famous picture now, of you holding the Israeli flag on Har HaBayit. But congratulations, Lauren. I think you've made an important statement. And it's worth reflecting that it is sometimes the women who have the most principled support for Israel. We learn this from the time of the Torah story of the spies, and they brought back the adverse report. It was the women that wanted to proceed into the land of Israel, and the men got shaking knees.
Right.
You're a true Eshet Chayil.
Toda, thank you. Well, I try, and you know, I think we can only try our best, right? Each person can do a little bit in their corner of the world, and everything we do, every time we stand up, it makes an impact for the entire Jewish world. And please God, we're moving forward in a positive direction for Jews and Zionists everywhere.
Well, you're an inspiration, Lauren, and I hope that you continue to inspire people. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you for having me.